This is what the path of a hurricane looks like from the air. The storm left trees scattered like matchsticks on the hills.
Look at how these trees are just stripped of foliage here. You can actually see the roofs of homes on the hilltops. The roof just blown away.
Hurricane Matthew killed hundreds of people and left tens of thousands homeless. We're flying over Haiti's southwestern peninsula, one of the most isolated parts of the country.
This is the only real way that we can get a sense of the scale of the damage caused by Hurricane Matthew, because Haiti does not have a great network of roads, and there are a series of islands off of Haiti's coast, like Île La Vache, what we're looking at right now.
6 years ago, this region was largely untouched by the earthquake that shattered the Haitian capital.
Bonjour, ça va?
But this time, the people here weren't so lucky.
How is your house?
My house broke down. Everything goes.
Everything's gone.
Yeah. That's sad. All the trees was going down. Electric pole was down.
Since the storm, residents of Port Salut cleaned much of the debris off the roads. But at night, they sleep outside their shattered homes in the dark.
When do you think you'll get electricity here again?
Nobody know when.
This is a close-up view of some of the damage that we could see from the sky. Just one home that was ripped apart by the hurricane winds that made a mess of people's meager belongings and hurt a lot of people here too, who had to wait days for emergency medical care.
These people survived the most powerful hurricane their country has seen in a generation. A grim reminder of the fury and power of Mother Nature. Ivan Watson, CNN, Port Salut, Haiti.